Today, we're going to give you a walkthrough of our van's electrical system, from inverters, batteries, our charging system, solar system, absolutely everything. We rebuilt our electrical system, veering away from Renogy products. Previously, we had Renogy all over in our van. We had Renogy batteries and Renogy chargers, and two of their products failed on us, and with horrible customer service, we decided to completely veer away from those products and go for a higher quality of products for our batteries, our chargers, solar, the lot. From cold weather performance in the middle of winter to real life scenarios, you'll see why we've changed our electrical setup. First off, here's a quick look at our whole setup completely, and then we'll go through each part separately. The system powers everything in our van, from basics like lights and fridge to heavier loads such as an inverter, which powers our kettle for the very important coffee. Starting at the source of our system are our super reliable lithium batteries from Super B, which we'll highlight in detail soon. They're connected to 5 12-volt circuit breakers, which then connect to our 2000 watt inverter, Victron solar charge controller, a distribution panel, and a Victron DC to DC charger. We've designed this system to be as efficient and reliable as possible. Previously, with our Renogy products, we found that they weren't as reliable as we wanted to, and they failed within a year. So when we upgraded our electrical system, we really wanted to make sure that we put emphasis on reliability. So starting at the source of our electrical system, we've got two 150 amp hour Super B batteries. They are smart, self-heating lithium batteries with their own individual BMS. We've connected them in parallel and also connected the BMS together. That way, the BMS of each individual battery communicates together with the other one, making it for a very efficient and smart system. The batteries are then joined together in parallel to give us a total of 300 amp hours at 12 volts. One of the standout features of why we chose Super B is their exceptional charging efficiency in cold weather. Anyone who's lived off-grid in a cabin, a yacht, or a van knows how important it is to have the ability to charge your batteries when it's below freezing. If there's power coming into the battery system, the BMS will first use that energy to heat the battery cells to above 5 degrees before any charging will commence. This ensures that the battery cells aren't going to be damaged from charging at freezing temperatures. Also, when we built the van, we put a heater outlet for our diesel heater in the back of the van, because when it does get down to really, really cold, so -10+, we want to make sure that they are staying as warm as possible so that we can charge it whenever we need it. Well, that's the plan anyway. With our old batteries, I'm not going to name the brand or anything, we face issues with our charging capabilities and our discharging capabilities. Our charging capabilities were limited to 50 amps continuous and a reduced discharge at 100 amps continuous. So with our old charging setup, we had a 40 amp DC charger and a 40 amp solar charger. So this meant that every time we drove, we had to turn off one of those chargers to keep it below 50 amps. Most of the time, this meant turning off the solar charger to ensure just the DC to DC charger was charging at 40 amps continuous. If we left them both on and drove, this would be over 50 amps continuous and could potentially damage our Renogy batteries. And with discharging, we couldn't discharge over 100 amps, which means we couldn't use anything roughly over 1000 watts with the inverter. This meant making coffee with our kettle in the mornings a real hassle. But with our Super B batteries now, these worries are a thing of the past. Whether we're charging from solar, shore power, or while driving, the performance remains consistent. Now we can have a maximum charge current into our batteries at 135 amps, which is well above what we'll be able to generate. And we can also have a discharge continuous at 200 amps, which ensures those morning coffees are a lot easier to make, as we can boil our kettle finally using the inverter. This level of reliability means that we don't have to worry about losing power when we're off-grid for a long period of time. For example, during our recent ski touring trip where we were parked up for 3 days, we never once had to worry about our batteries. These batteries powered everything from our kettle every day, heaters, lights, pumps, our inverter, charging our camera to ensure that it was always charged, and we never had a problem once. With batteries being the most important part of electrical setup, we really wanted to ask ourselves, why do we want to choose a Super B battery? Well, let's break it down. First, reliability. When you're off-grid as much as we are, you need a system you can count on and not have to worry about. In our previous system, we had failing chargers, failing solar, and we were constantly worrying about the next thing that was going to go wrong. We don't want to have that anymore. Super B batteries are built to last, and they've proven it themselves. They're not a company that makes multiple products, solar panels, chargers, everything. They simply make batteries and that's it. And they specialize in batteries, making the highest quality possible. They're continually improving their batteries. Even once you bought them, they release updates regularly for you to update the BMS on the battery you've installed. I originally thought this was just a selling point, but much to my surprise, I've done 2 updates since getting them. Last week, I received an update which included improved low power modes for the BMS on self-consumption, meaning that when your batteries get really low, it will limit how much power your BMS uses to ensure it doesn't drain the battery even faster. Plus new log types, added new Bluetooth features, plus a lot more, but I really have no idea what it all means. The second reason we chose Super B batteries was because of the performance. These batteries deliver consistent power even under heavy loads, and while the batteries are running lower and lower. Even when we're boiling the jug, oftentimes we're still using the heater, the pump, and other things. So with our kettle, we're using about 130 amps, plus a pump, plus lights, plus a heater. So we're probably looking at about 150 amps in total going through our system. Even when we were down to as low as 35% recently, it didn't miss a beat. It still just pumped power out as if it was still at 100%. And thirdly, and most importantly, is Super B's customer service. We've never really experienced anything quite like this. Super B will help you out with any questions you have and generally get back to you within 24 hours. For our setup, they took all the information we had about our old system and suggested areas where I should change things in order to have a more effective and efficient system. Originally, when we were looking at getting these batteries, I had some questions to them to ensure that these batteries were actually going to be what I wanted. And they got back to me super fast and said, hey, maybe you should upgrade your fuse, your cables, your this, your that, to ensure that these batteries have the best chance of performing at the high level that you want. After having horrific customer service through other companies, it really puts my mind at ease to be able to deal with a company that actually cares about its customers. Changing our old system batteries to a new system of batteries was pretty straightforward. Originally, I was just going to keep everything the same. However, once I sent a photo and a small diagram of what I had to Super B, the engineering department got back to me and said, hey, maybe you should upgrade your main switch to a 300 amp fuse, and also you should upgrade your cables to 90 amp. That way, it'll be best for the longevity of the batteries and your system in total. We connected both batteries in parallel and connected the BMS of both batteries together along with a battery monitor, which they communicate directly through. And just like that, we were able to integrate them into our new system. So our batteries are charged in three different ways. We have a 30 amp, 230 volt Victron charger, which is connected to the mains power whenever we're at a campsite or something. We have a 30 amp DC to DC charger made by Victron as well. That way, every time we drive, it's always topped up. And we have 400 watts of solar on the roof made by EcoWorthy, which goes down to a Victron solar charger. All these can be monitored very easily by the Victron Bluetooth app in our phone. We can change the settings in each charger to ensure the chargers are optimized for the batteries. Also in the app, it groups all the different chargers together, allowing you to switch between each effortlessly. I created a Super B preset in my app for the batteries. That way, in the Victron app, I can just go up and select Super B, and then all the charging parameters are the same across each individual charger. I'll see if I can link it below and you'll be able to download it and put it on your charger. Apart from that, we have a distribution panel which has all our 12 volt fuses in it. That powers things like our lights, fridge, our heater, and anything else that is powered by 12 volt. Also, we kept our 2000 watt Renogy inverter, which runs our laptops, camera chargers, and most importantly, our kettle. For monitoring how everything is performing in our van, we have a Simmering Pico system, which tells us our battery levels, tank levels, and temperatures of everything. Also, we have a separate battery monitor in the back of the van in the garage area, which is made by Super B, which communicates directly with the BMS, which probably gives a bit more of an accurate readout. If you want to know more about our monitoring system, drop a comment below and maybe we'll make a video in the future. So that's our electrical system, powered by Super B, charged by Victron. We hope this walkthrough has given you some insights into why we chose these batteries and chargers and how it's improved our life on the road.